I'm Chris.
And I'm Gav.
And this is the Retro Saga.
At the end of part one, I was pondering whether or not to get Pro Vortec there.
Decisions, Gav.
Did you get it?
Under there, 45.
Well, did you get it?
Try and bundle it.
Did you get it?
No, I regret not getting it, but I didn't get it.
What's the difference, mate? What's the difference? It's got no instructions.
How much is a manual difference, eh?
More than a pound. I haven't even got a Sega CD, but I'm having it.
What is it?
Road Rager.
Avenger.
Avenger.
I paid £1 for this Road Avenger manual. And Sega Arcade Collection.
Power glove on the next door for 90 quid.
Okay. What was that, Gav? Pro Vortec there. £45. Oh, he'll give you a fair tenner.
Sure.
Tenner?
But he took it in for free.
That's the boss.
Did you see the boss?
I didn't see the boss.
And let's have a kill. There's full-size DVDs.
What's the point?
Tor Jaminel, Panic on Funkatron. What a game. £12. You're not Gav.
It's not a very good game though.
I thought it was awesome. So I've just seen another one here. Where's it at?
Sorry,
oh, Spectrum Games. Mutant League Football. Sweet. I love the power glove, it's so bad. £90 is just a bit too much.
Some video games we've got hand.
No, don't copy on YouTube.
Too late.
For these prices you will be.
Channel
call.
Right. Well, they were good games, just expensive prices. Sunset Riders, Kid Icarus, Gargoyles 2.
It's a basic Kirby game.
Or is it different? I think it's slightly different in some way. I don't think it's like, you know, your thumb pack, but the one that had like the sound. I think that might have some kind of gimmick to it, I can't think. I get confused because there's a couple of different ones for SNES, and there's two, there's that one, and no one can't get anywhere now. That's probably more normal than the other one. I think the other one's a little bit cheaper. I think that's more closer to a normal Kirby game.
I'm after like just a Kirby game, yeah. You know. And
I know.
I'll get this home and it'll be like Dr. Mario or something like that, you know.
Have you got there, Gav?
It is Dr. Mario.
Have you got there, Gav? How much? 28. Are you getting them? Like, oh, we're going to try them.
Would you bundle, mate?
What kind of bundle are we looking at?
For them all, yeah?
Yeah.
We'll see what we can do for you. Some of what? Pasta on there,
yeah. Be kind, my friend.
Be kind. Kind as I can be, on something.
What was yours? 40. Mine was 44, I think. It's like 84. It's 3.70 or something.
Be nice.
Yeah?
Be nice. Yeah, 70 quid would be nice.
Let's get outside.
75.
75?
Yeah.
Did you do 70?
I'm not slow as 70 now. 73.
73. Yeah. We'll go for 73.
Team Chav.
What have you asked how much it is?
15 quid it says on the thing there.
Mario Paint.
Mario Paint, full inbox. You ever played it?
Yeah.
Do you want it or not?
No.
Will you drop this down to a tenner? 12. It's for this manner, you're not me.
Nah, I'm alright.
No?
Tenner I might have, but.
Tenner?
Yeah, go on.
Go on, £10.
I wasn't even bothered about getting it, to be honest.
And I didn't realise how unbothered you were until I watched the footage back.
Yeah. It was like, 15 quid is a good price. I wasn't arguing that, but I just didn't want it for a tenner. I would have probably spent it.
Perfect in box. Mouse mat, mouse, game, it's all brilliant in there. And awesome, awesome shelf filler. And I don't know why I was haggling for Gav. He pointed out, so I thought he was interested, but no, he was just pointed out. Then, for some reason, I haggled it down for Gav and got an awesome purchase for Gav.
Yeah.
Could be mine, it is mine. I'm keeping it.
I can make one, yeah.
How much is your Mega Drive, man?
I think it's 150 for the Mega Drive.
Who painted it, you?
No,
nice job, like really nice.
It's the best one I've seen. Custom Mega Drive, it's awesome.
What is it, acrylics?
Yeah, acrylics and enamel spray paint. And
just a lacquer over the top. It's really nice, like.
Some of the best I've seen.
Really good ones, yeah. They did a nice job of painting them up and everything.
£150 though.
Yeah, they turned a £20 to £30 console into £150 worth for a bit of paint.
Yeah.
I might do some myself.
We might do some.
Yeah, and I might design it on Mario Paint.
Yeah. Getting another purchase?
£20. How much is Yoshi's story on there?
It's a bit knackered, isn't it? £13, the label's a bit.
I know it sounds silly, but it's over.
Awesome, your game, your nan, and you have to push dominoes over to get to the end. I had an import from America when I was a kid, my dad got from Patrick Martin, and that put me in. It was the only American game I had, and it was awesome. Then we broke the import, so we couldn't play it no more. Me and my brother were fighting, we were all over on the computer, and it snapped the contacts off, so I couldn't play pushover no more.
So you got pushed over on a pushover?
£9.
Get it?
I don't know, I might try and bundle something later because I've got my eye on Spider-Man for the NES. So I might try and do a bit of a bundle if I see anything else I like. We'll see what happens. Gab doing some searching, seeing if he already owns the games.
These days I've got that many PS2 games, I have to have an app so I can keep track of what I've got and what I haven't got.
Have you got games you got?
Two Ratchet and Clanks and two Siphon Fillers.
Two Siphon Fillers?
Yeah.
What, one and two?
One and two. I want to see how much he wants for it.
Give it a go.
It's a random box apparently.
Mega Man collection down there on the GameCube.
How much?
40 quid I think, or was it 30? Oh yeah, all this. Yeah. I'll just say nothing.
Well, that's it for part two. So, what got you so excited, Chris? Looks like we're going to have to wait part three to find out. It is Dr. Mario.
Oopsie.
Oops.